Hi guys, I'm Naveen Krishnan from the Nikon India technical team. For this production, I've been given the job of behind the scenes, which you'll be seeing a lot. We have also been using an audio setup for recording sounds. If you have already seen our video, it doesn't use a lot of vocals and dialogues, but we still did use a lot of ambient sound apart from the music that has been played. So the major reason for using such an audio system is to record audio behind the scenes. So I'll quickly run you through the kind of setups that we have been using for recording. So what you see here is a cordless lapel recorder. As you can easily hear, when I opened up my jacket, this is also picking up a lot of ambient sound. And if you could just zoom out a little bit. Our crew member Arun is holding a boom pole with a shotgun mic, which is a unidirectional mic, and it's ideal for recording vocal ranges because it cuts out almost all the ambient sound. The person standing next to him, Shantanu, he's holding the recording device, which is a zoom recorder, and this can take two microphone inputs, so which means you can simultaneously use two microphones for the same shot and get the same kind of audio without much of an ambient disturbance. So that's it for the time being. We have to rush back to the shoot.
Hi, this is Satya from Nikon India technical team. I have been given the responsibility of directing and doing cinematography for this production that we are doing in Ladakh. We are shooting the intro scene of Rohan and Abhishek entering the monastery. So this scene is planned with a slider with a tele lens on it. So we have a left to right movement of the slider where Aman will be giving a flare from there just for the cinematic effect. And we have chosen this foreground to maintain a foreground, middle ground and a background kind of a feel. So hence the light is so harsh. What I've done is that I've used couple of NDs to cut down the light and to attain shallow depth of field. Talking about the color temperature, I'm going with a fixed color temperature of say 5600 Kelvin for the whole movie.
Hi guys, this is Aman from Nikon India technical team, and right now I'm at the bank of Pangong So. For this movie production, my role was as the second cameraman, where I was aiding the master cam with the help of a telephoto lens. The benefit of having a second cameraman is you're able to have a different magnification, a different angle of view, as well as shooting with multiple cam helps make the task much more easier. Now this shot is all about covering Rohan and Abhishek shooting the valley, and Satya is doing a wide angle shot and I am doing a tele shot where we will be intercutting and using those shots. Since it's a static shot, what we have to take care is of the focusing. We'll be using we are using AFS and we are keeping it static. And as far as this cloth is concerned in my hand, this is used to take care of the exposure. While we're in the out, it's pretty bright and it's difficult to understand what is the right exposure, so such cloths are very important when we're shooting videos. And again, since we'll be changing another position, so we'll be back with more tips.
Basically what we do here is we are trying to capture the two subjects moving from left of the frame to right of the frame, where we see the reflection of the subject in the water. So actually the sun is pretty harsh, so we have put on NDs to cut down light. So this is ND8, which nearly cuts down 3 stops of light. So now we have an exposure. Why we use this is because to get a cinematic look and to get a better shallow depth of field.
I'm here to talk about lensing, especially the lenses that are being used for the main movie, which Satya and Aman are using. They are using a 24-70 2.8 and a 70-200 2.8, both of which offers excellent low light performance as well as shallow depth of field. Here it's majorly being used for a shallow depth of field, which gives you a kind of a cinematic effect. If you compare, you know, those cinema lenses which are mounted on cine cameras, they are much more heavier and they are more expensive as well as compared to DSLR lenses. The best part about prime lenses is you don't need, or you don't always need a 70-200. If you are a beginner, you can even start with a 50mm 1.8 or a 35mm 1.8 depending on your choice of framing. If you want to go slightly higher above that to step up your game, probably go for an 85 1.4 or a 50 1.4, which are block lenses, which again, like I said, offers excellent low light performance and shallow depth of field.
We are at the Thiksay Monastery, as you can see it in the background. Today again we are shooting a scene over here. I would like to share a small tip with all of you is regarding lensing. The lenses which you will get to see mostly in our movie is the prime lenses. The reason to do that is with the help of prime lenses it's much more easier to do focus pulling, and when you're doing manual focus it's easier to track a subject even when there is a change in contrast when you're tracking it away or towards the camera. Also, you'll get to see a lot of biking shots. In those shots we have used telephoto lenses. The reason to do that is that the property of a telephoto lens is to compress the background. Similarly, the property of a wide angle lens is to throw away everything, and the subjects which are much more closer to the subject, to the camera, look much more bigger rather than the background. So these are the techniques which we have been using in our movie so far, and if we try out something else or something new, I would surely be back to share the same with you again.
We are heading towards Turtuk, which is in the Nubra Valley, and we've stopped in between at a location where we have a straight road, and as you can see in the far background we have Rohan and Abhishek. They'll be walking down this road, and we have two cameras placed over here. One is at a tele and another one is on a wide. We'll be intercutting those shots and using them, as well as in the background you can see Naveen taking the montage of the whole landscape out there. So we'll be using these clips as well all together joined. And as far as the settings are concerned, again we are shooting at full HD at 24p for more cinematic view, as per the exposure. So we'll be changing our shutter speeds and apertures, but as per the rule we are keeping our shutter speed at 1/50th. We are using apertures at f9 and f11, ISOs at the lowest possible.
Hi guys, I am Anindo Basu, part of Nikon India technical team, and for this production I was given the role of AD, which stands for Assistant Director.
Here's we taking you into another BTS scene. You must see this shot, and we want to break this shot down for you. We are currently at Changla Pass and it's situated at a height of 17,000 feet, and you can see the snow behind. We are covered in snow everywhere, you can see. And also in this height you are having a little breathing problem, everyone's having a breathing problem, but then we are still shooting because we want to show a dynamic shot where two bikes come from each end and converse together. So this is the only location where we found snow and we wanted to take this shot. And you can see behind me there is Naveen who is taking care of the tele lens, and there is another one mounted on a wide angle. So we are taking two shots, same, we have placed the cameras almost at the same location, and we want to take that shot because as you can see they come in behind me, and this is the shot that you'll get to see in the final one. What I want to tell you that even though this we've chosen such a difficult location, but still coordination and getting your accessories right, and even you can see the cameras are working perfectly fine at this height also. So that is the utility. You'll have to choose your cameras right, you'll have to choose your lens right, so that at any point of time you don't fail with your equipments.
So hi guys, here we are at Nubra Valley shooting a scene where Abhishek and Rohan are hitchhiking a car. You can see them behind me and Satya explaining the scene to them. So I'll tell you behind the scene what are the settings that Satya is keeping, or what are the parameters that you need to keep in your mind when you're shooting a scene like this. First thing being your set picture control. In your camera shooting menu you have the set picture control option, through which you can control the contrast, brightness, saturation, clarity, and overall you control the look and feel of the scene. So do that beforehand so that you save a lot of time when you sit on the editing table, and you don't need to think about what sharpness to increase or whatever, like contrast or major or smaller things that needs to be kept in mind. In Nikon cameras, we have introduced a new picture control, which is the flat picture control, and which is basically meant for movies or video shooting. So what you can do is you can select the flat picture control option, and it will automatically reduce the contrast of the scene and give you better highlights and shadow details. And apart from that, you have your white balance option, same as your still photography. Select direct sunlight, because as you can see, we are under direct sunlight right now, and we can select the direct sunlight option to give us the best colors possible.
Hi guys, you just saw Abhishek and Rohan take this shot over here in the same location. So I'm just gonna brief you about the settings that Satya kept. Firstly, if you think about the settings, first what we do is we try to set our frame rate. So he was taking his frame rate at 24 frames per second, and accordingly we set our shutter speed to the double. So 1/48 is not available, so the closest one is 1/50th of a shutter speed. So we keep our shutter speed double the amount of frame rate that we keep in our cameras. And also, what I would suggest is whenever you're setting up your camera, do check your monitor brightness. Because a lot of time what happens is you've set your monitor brightness high, and because of that, when you play back your videos or play back your images, maybe you'll see them as overexposed. So check your monitor brightness before you start shooting, and that will help you check the right exposure.